Welcome to the shooting show. This week it's something a little bit different, as I'm strapped to Corporal Mike French from the Red Devils display team and thrown out of an aeroplane to raise funds for Save the Rhino. Plus we bring you all the latest from the big one, the game fair at Hatfield House.
Regular viewers will remember Stuart and myself guiding Mike French and Steve Handley from the Parachute Regiment Red Devils display team a few weeks ago. Stuart put Steve onto a cracker of a roebuck. And after a few tense moments and a timely whistle to check the buck's progress, Steve proved his worth as a rifleman and grassed what could be a bronze medal buck on his debut outing. His elation at a job well done was plain to see. Frenchie under my wing wasn't to be outdone, and we soon dropped onto an unusual malform. He fitted to the rifle like a pro.
Good shot, mate.
That made a brace of bucks grassed in very short order. Grassing quality bucks in tandem is the exception rather than the rule, but it's no less enjoyable, and I do like it when a plan comes together. Teaming up, we walk into Steve's buck for the lowdown before the guys chuck me out of a plane.
So, good roebuck for your first roebuck. That's exceptional, Steve.
Yeah, it looks pretty good.
Yeah. So what did you think of your first experience?
Yeah, it was good. Got the juices flowing.
Good. So what did you think, Frenchie?
Yeah, great. First time out. Didn't take that long either. I thought we'd be out here for a few hours, so it's nice. Yeah, put around the wood line and...
You're with the air team now, mate.
That's it. Yeah, cheers, Pete. It's a good little morning out. I think it's our turn next. Take you down and throw you out an aeroplane for the afternoon.
Hi there, Pete.
Hi.
How you doing?
Yeah, all good.
So tell us why you're in this red suit with these semi-attractive men stood next to you.
Oh.
Okay, really attractive.
It's a jump for fundraiser for Save the Rhino. So I'm here for Cathy, Susie and Joe. £3,000.
Yeah, I would be nervous as well. What about the guy on your left? Getting close, Cap. Do you know what I mean? Don't be shy.
Join in as well.
Okay, so how much money did you raise?
£3,000.
Do you reckon if we show this video afterwards, you can get some more money?
Yeah, so
keep donating. And today we're going to jump from 13,000 feet. We're going to get out the aircraft, slightly different to what we normally do today. We're going to have the two guys outside here. They're going to swoop down. They're going to take an hand each. It's going to make an awesome photo. And then at about 6,000 feet, they're going to break off. Your parachute's going to hopefully open. And then mine's going to hopefully open. And so the other two will fly up to them. But we're going to land safely, and you're going to say you want to. Excited? Okay, let's have a great skydive.
I can't escape. Well done. Well done.
Brilliant.
Welcome to skydiving.
Well done, Pete. How was that?
Fantastic.
Did you have a good time?
Yeah, brilliant.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So, you reckon we can get some more money raised for the rhinos?
Yeah, dig deep, guys.
Yeah, dig deep. Sweet.
The rhinos need it.
Excellent. Well done and welcome to skydiving.
No, thank you very much. Cheers, well. Guys.
Hunting for conservation there were the Red Devils. And now, all the latest news from Hatfield House Game Fair.
This is the Shooting Show News. This week we report from Hatfield House. It's the Game Fair 2017. Coming to the Hertfordshire location for the first time ever, this year's Game Fair brought a celebration of the countryside to the Marquess of Salisbury's estate just a few miles from London. Gunmakers Row had just as strong a country feel as ever, with the biggest names in the fieldsports world convening on this flagship event. Even a bit of rain didn't put off the punters, who seemed as happy as ever despite the mud. Naturally, waterproof clothing was a popular product at the show, as the team at Deer Hunter found out.
It's a new location, it's very nice, the attendance is very, very good, but people seem to be enjoying it. It's called Gamekeeper, it's a stormliner fleece, so ideal for this time of year. It was launched for spring-summer, obviously taking us into early partridge season. So it's got cartridge pockets, it's a stormliner fleece, so it's waterproof, lightweight, obviously stylish, shooting pad, foam pocket, bits and pieces, you know. And there's also a waistcoat version as well, which is selling particularly well on a day like today. So partridge season, even early pheasants, you know, certainly in the south of England, you know, where the weather's a little warmer. And if we continue to have winters the way we have, maybe the whole season.
It was a big show for optics. Carlis showed off its revamped helioscope range, Swarovski had samples of its smart DS scope, and Browning's new Kite optics brand attracted plenty of attention. But it wasn't all about glass. Digital envy is big too, as ATN told us.
We have quite a lot of interest, specifically at this show. People coming in that are traditionally more drawn to the lamp in that they're now realising the benefits of digital night vision. Customer bases, there's a broad spectrum, just to go over a few. So we have some guys from safaris and stuff, you know, South Africa safaris coming in, all, you know, from that sort of thing all the way up to the UK foxer, you know, deer stalkers, just farmers having, you know, rabbit problems, things like that. Mainly the day and night, the digital day and night, which is the X-Lite 2 that we do. I've actually got the 314 model with me now. That's been generating the most bit of interest, just due to the change really in the shooting industry, especially when it comes to the pest control. It just makes it you know, a lot less things to be switching around and stuff like that. Popping glass off to put your traditional night vision back on now is sort of becoming a thing of the past. Just keep one rifle on the one scope on the rifle, and you're good for the, you know, whatever you're doing. Really.
And now onto the guns. First, we got a sneak preview of Perazzi's new MXS.
The term brand new is fairly relative because the action, everything else is the same, but it is a complete makeover. The original MXS was fairly heavily engraved, which you may pick up over my left shoulder. And for a lot of people, the engraving was too much, and we needed to sort of reflect on that and to come up with something that's somewhat more subtle. So we've gone completely the other way. This is the new version. This gun arrived last Wednesday, so it is brand new off the rack. We've gone from heavy writing to just a small Perazzi logo MXS. This, the nickel action, we also will have the black action, two barrel lengths, 30, 32, and two stock options. So it's a gun that's going to retail just over round about £6,000, up against other guns similar prices. However, the advantage of this one is that you have the six options to choose from for your money.
The show marked a milestone for the return of Remington to the UK. We got the latest on this big brand's plans.
So Remington products largely been unavailable here in the UK for some time now, and certainly like the rifle we're seeing here today, it's a new release product outside of the US, relatively unseen by the rest of the world market. Ray Trade UK expanded from sister company to Ray Trade in Australia and ventured into the UK market in the latter part of last year, and now doing hopefully some good things with Remington over the year. Well, the brands have been received very well, so not just Remington but also Marlin Firearms, Marlin Lever Action. Firearms have been extremely popular in a few chamberings and a growing market in the gallery shooting sector here in the UK as well, so it's been wonderful to be able to offer those too. Yeah. A particular model is a new model 700 long range, so based on Remington's famous model 700 action. It's available in a heavy barrel varmint style, so anyone wanting to stretch the legs and start reaching out to targets beyond 600 yards, a fine option there. Comes in a Bell & Carson's M44 tactical stock, new one for the 2017 product range. But screw cut standard, offered, like I say, in long and magnum chambering. So a gun that's going to retail for just under £1,000, and great value for buyers. Glass reinforced stock, it's out the box, a very good shooter, and anyone venturing into the long range market, a great option.
Cesar Guarini had recently taken delivery of their new Invictus M-Spec, and we headed over to check it out.
Some 4 or 5 years ago, the Richard Folds actually asked for a fixed choke gun, sporter. And since that time, we get a number of requests. Certain shooters who just don't want multiple choke. So this gun has been under development for the last 2 or 3 years. It also incorporates a new tapered rib on this particular model, which goes from 10 down to 5mm. It has that tendency to really channel the eye down to the rib. Available in 30-inch and in 32-inch. It has new stock dimensions to it. A complete new trigger mechanism called the DTS trigger system, where they take all the components to the hand polishing shop. Every component is hand polished and then is chromium plated, giving a very, very smooth trigger pull. You can put a million rounds through one of these, and when you think that you've shot the gun off the face, it's not so. You simply request from the UK an Invictus spares kit. Remove the cams and replace the cams with the two new cams provided. Release the center block and replace, same tool is used to replace the center block. And you are pulling the gun straight back on its face. Deliveries arriving in next week. So they'll be available to purchase as of Wednesday of next week.
Finally, there's always something new from Italian firearms giant Beretta. At their stand, it was a new semi-auto that really drew in the crowds.
This is the new A400 XL Black Edition. It's the latest edition in the XL range. It has a retail price of just over £2,000 with a kickoff system and just under £2,000 without the kickoff system. It features a carbon rib, which helps to dissipate the heat, and it has a fast bolt release to make it easier for competition shooters to load, and an enlarged bolt handle for ease of operation. It has an opti-choke barrel system, barrel with opti-choke chokes, HP chokes, which are black to match the rest of the gun. And it has a B-fast balance system in the stock so that the shooter can balance the gun to suit his own personal taste. It's new to the market and we think it'll be a great success. Autos are very popular with pigeon shooters because they're easy to load in a hide. Obviously this gun with the enlarged bolt release is perfect for fast handling, so yeah, it could be used in a pigeon hide equally well. The Black Edition series, this is the third gun in the Black Edition series. We had a Black Edition DT11, we had a Black Edition 692, and this is the third gun in the Black Edition trilogy, so it's been very well received, as have the other two, yeah.
We'll see you at Ragley for the Game Fair 2018. Until then, that was the Shooting Show News.
Well, that's it for this week. Thanks for watching. Please like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. And if you're not a member of BASC, it's time to join now. BASC, looking after your sport, looking after you. This has been The Shooting Show.